It's me, Keen. Welcome back to the Naio Nails channel. In this video, I'm going to show you how to do a flame design using Acrygel. All will be revealed. So I'm going to work on a tip today. I'm going to buff the tip just to take away the shine. I'm going to be using Acrygel, and if you use Acrygel, you put on the base coat first. So this is the Urban Graffiti base coat, so that needs to go on first. If you put that over a shiny surface, it will not stick. So you need to have a buffed surface. So I'm going to put the Urban Graffiti base coat on first, just like I said. Pop that into the lamp, give that a cure, so that's nice and cured. Then what we're going to do, we're going to use these Acrygels. So we've got two Luminous ones, so they will glow in the dark, and then we've also got In Bloom, which will change colour when it's hot and cold. I'm going to take this, squeeze this out first. Pull that down the nail. Then we've got Glow Stick. I'm just going to choose a different section for that. It's going to look like a big old mess. Then we've got Illuminate. I'm going to take off a little bit of that. I just think I went a little bit too crazy with the amount of In Bloom that we put on. In my dampened dish, I'm going to put some Gel Residue Wipe Off solution in there because I'll need that in my brush to stop the Acrygel from sticking to my brush. So you're going to go into the liquid and just take off the excess. I'm going to arrange this here at the top part by the cuticle first. And then I'm going to fold, kind of swirl the Acrygel into each other so you get movement like a flame. I'm going to take a little bit more glow stick. I feel like I need a bit of that just for contrast. I'm going to put that there. Don't worry about it being kind of lumpy bumpy at this stage because it will be filed. It's about getting that folding and that movement right. So you can see I'm kind of moving it around until I'm happy with where everything is. What we do with just a little bit of In Bloom just in that section there, just to break it up a little bit. Yeah, that's much better. Thank you. I'm just going to cure that now. Right, so what I'm going to do now is take off the sticky layer. So you can see how that's changed colour already because it went into the lamp and it got warm. So that's kind of cool. And I'm going to neaten up the shape, because obviously we've done a lot of folding and the shape will look a little bit lumpy bumpy. Right, let's wipe over that, get rid of the dust.
Yeah, I think that'll look lovely when the body heat makes the top red as well.
Well, it's cold. What we're going to do now is we're going to actually put some black onto it as well and kind of frame parts of it to make it look more flame-like. Because yeah, it does look kind of cool like this. So it's the cold that will make it go red.
So it's like, can you see, as I'm
putting the gel residue wipe off solution onto it, which is colder, it's changing the colour. Right, so yes, it looks cool like that. It looks flamey, but we're going to make it look extra, extra flamey. So we're going to take Serious Black from the Urban Graffiti Gel Polish range. So I'm going to take a pencil and sketch out my flames. So it's the round sections that we will be filling in black. So don't get confused and start filling in the other section, because you will just ruin the design. I am going to cure each section as I go, because I know, and you probably know what I'm like, and I'll just end up smudging it and just, yeah, messing it all up, and I don't want to do that.
Oh wow.
See, it's coming together, isn't it now? I have the best ideas when I'm trying to sleep at night.
Not the best sleep though.
Not the best sleep. You always think when you do this kind of reverse way of doing flames, the sections that we're painting right now kind of look like drips.
Yeah, like slime.
Yeah. But then you're left with the flame shapes. Thank you. Right, let's pop that in the lamp. Right, so what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go over with a second layer just so I've got, you know, super black, because as I hold that up to the light, I can see bits that are slightly transparent. Not all of it is, but there are some parts. And when this kind of glows in the dark as well, I want to block out that light. So I'm just going to quickly go over. This is a lot easier than doing the first layer, to be honest, because you've got such a good guide to go against. But I do think it's really important to like pencil out that drawing so you can really visualize it. I struggle to visualize it myself. I needed to pencil it out. What I'm going to do first of all is I'm going to give it a top coat. I'm going to use the shiny top coat, but I'm actually going to finish with matte. The reason I'm going to do a shiny top coat is I feel like the shiny top coat self-levels a little bit better and we'll get a smoother finish that allow me to just buff the nail a little bit. When you're working with gel polish, you're gonna get a little bit of thickness from the gel polish, so that's what we kind of want to get rid of. So I'm going to give this a buff. And what this will do, it'll just smooth the nail so we get a smoother finish when we come to put the matte top coat on. I find this way a little bit easier. I know some of you might be thinking, well, why don't you just put the matte on and then buff the matte? Honest to God, this does work a lot better. So let's top coat this with the matte top coat now. This is the ultra matte. So that's what it looks like when it's warm. And then if you live in a cold climate, like our great British weather at the minute, this is what it will look like. Get the water off.
Oh my gosh.
It's cool too.
Yeah, very nice. Love it. Especially when it's cold.
Yeah. I love it. It's cool. Or hot. It's damn hot. So there you are, guys. Hope you've enjoyed this video. Don't forget to check us out on Facebook and Instagram. All the products that I've used today for this design will be linked below in the description box, and I will see you in the next video. So, bye-bye.